May I welcome you to our service of Matins, the sixth Sunday of Easter. This week, the readings come from St. Mary's Hawkesbury with Mike and Pam Bendry, and I am here in this beautiful church on my own, and I will be preaching from here today.
Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Dearly beloved brethren, the scripture moveth us in sundry places to acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, and that we should not dissemble nor cloak them before the face of Almighty God our Heavenly Father, but confess them with an humble, lowly, penitent, and obedient heart, to the end that we may obtain forgiveness of the same by his infinite goodness and mercy. And although we ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before God, yet ought we most chiefly so to do when we assemble and meet together to render thanks for the great benefits that we have received at his hands, to set forth his most worthy praise, to hear his most holy word, and to ask those things which are requisite and necessary, as well for the body as the soul. Wherefore I pray and beseech you, as many as are here present, to accompany me with a pure heart and humble voice unto the throne of the heavenly grace, saying after me.
Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and there is no health in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and hath given power and commandment to his ministers to declare and pronounce to his people, being penitent, the absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our mouth shall show forth thy praise.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Let us say together the Venite. O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the strength of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and show ourselves glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are all the corners of the earth, and the strength of the hills is his also. The sea is his, and he made it, and his hands prepared the dry land. O come, let us worship and fall down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is the Lord our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts, as in the provocation, and as in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tempted me, proved me, and saw my works. 40 years long was I grieved with this generation, and said, It is a people that do err in their hearts, for they have not known my ways, unto whom I swear in my wrath, that they should not enter into my rest. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear. Do not be frightened, but in your hearts set apart Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect, keeping a clear conscience, so that those that speak maliciously against your good behaviour in Christ may be ashamed of their slander. It is better, if it is God's will, to suffer for doing good than for doing evil. For Christ died for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, to bring you to God. He was put to death in the body, but made alive by the Spirit, through whom also he went and preached to the spirits in prison, who disobeyed long ago, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah while the ark was being built. In it, only a few people, 8 in all, were saved through the water. And this water symbolizes baptism now that saves you also. Not the removal of dirt from the body, but the pledge of a good conscience towards God. It saves you by the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at God's right hand, with angels, authorities, and powers in submission to him. Here ends the first reading.
Praise our God, ye people, and make the voice of his praise to be heard, who holdeth our soul in life, and suffereth not our feet to slip. For thou, O God, hast proved us. Thou also hast tried us like as silver is tried. Thou broughtest us into the snare, and laidest trouble upon our loins. Thou sufferest men to ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, and thou broughtest us out into a wealthy place. I will go into thine house with burnt offerings, and will pay thee my vows, which I promised with my lips, and spake with my mouth when I was in trouble. I will offer unto thee fat burnt sacrifices with the incense of rams. I will offer bullocks and goats. O come hither and hearken, all ye that fear God. And I will tell you what he hath done for my soul. I called upon him with my mouth, and gave him praises with my tongue. If I incline unto wickedness with mine heart, the Lord will not hear me, but God hath heard me, and considered the voice of my prayer. Praised be God, who hath not cast out my prayer, nor turned his mercy from me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
If you love me, you will obey what I command. and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, the Spirit of Truth. The world cannot accept him, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he lives with you and will be in you. I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you. Before long, the world will not see me anymore, but you will see me. Because I live, you also will live. On that day, you will realize that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. Whoever has my commands and obeys them, he is the one who loves me. He who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love him and show myself to him. This is the end of the second reading.
Jubilate Deo. O be joyful in the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Be ye sure that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. O go your way into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and speak good of his name. For the Lord is gracious, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth from generation to generation. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen,
and mercifully hear us when we call upon thee.
Endue thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thine inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
because there is none other that fighteth for us but only thou, O God.
God, make clean our hearts within us,
and take not thy Holy Spirit from us.
God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
O God, who art the author of peace and lover of concord, in knowledge of whom standeth our eternal life, whose service is perfect freedom, defend us, thy humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in thy defence, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O Lord, our heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, who hast safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings may be ordered by thy governance, to do always that is righteous in thy sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the Church and the world and thank God for his goodness. We pray for our bishops, Rachel and Robert, and the Church throughout this Diocese of Gloucester. In our cycle of prayer today, we pray for the Diocese of Korea, for the province of Korea, Archbishop Mazes. In this diocese, we pray for the benefice of Gloucester, St. George with Wadden, Bruce Clifford, the parish priest, and Jonathan Mackenzie Jarvis, the reader. We also pray for the Diocese of Guildford, for Bishops Andrew and Joe, for the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Denmark, Bishop Henrik, for the Diocese of Western Tanganyika, Bishop Sadok. We remember those baptised at this time in our parishes, particularly Albert and Samuel Clark in Leighton. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our Queen and government, for all suffering from isolation or from the virus itself. We pray for the sick, those who need our prayers at this time, particularly Lorraine Hawkins, Jenny Harris, George Winch, O Lord our God, source of all goodness and love, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. We pray for those whose anniversaries of marriage fall at this time, particularly remembering Christopher and Lisa Overton and Richard and Amy Bournes. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Remember the recent departed and their families, particularly Joyce Emer and Graham Baker, and for those whose years and minds fall at this time, particularly Iris Phillips and John Mansfield. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgiving for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of thy love, and bring us all with them to thy eternal joy. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the souls of the departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, who hast given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications unto thee, and hast promised that when two or three are gathered together in thy name, thou wilt grant their requests. Fulfil now, O Lord, the desires and petitions of thy servants, as may be most expedient for them, granting us in this world knowledge of thy truth, and in the world to come life everlasting. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost, be with us all evermore. Amen.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Next week, we will be celebrating the Ascension and then Pentecost, the coming of the Holy Spirit on the Apostles. This event cemented the faith of the disciples before the mission to the wider world, which Pentecost sprung. Do you believe? Jesus asks Simon Peter, not just once, but three times. Lord, you know I believe, Peter replies. It was a time of challenging and a time of reaffirmation of faith, hardly surprising after the terrible disappointment of the crucifixion, when it seemed the whole mission of Jesus was dead and buried at Golgotha. So much for the kingdom of God. Thomas, you'll remember, couldn't believe what the other disciples were telling him. Unless I see for myself, I will not believe, he says stubbornly. And the following Sunday, when he sees the marks on the hands of Jesus at his side, he responds with what would one might call a profession of faith, using those infamous words, "My Lord and my God." Faith and belief was the continual question. Do you believe? Jesus asked this time and again, and never more so than during this period before the Ascension. But if belief is hard for the disciples who lived with Jesus, then how much more difficult is it for us who live in these secular days? As Richard Harris, the former Bishop of Oxford, says in an article in the Church Times, one of the problems faith confronts is the secular world in which we inhabit, or did inhabit, before the coronavirus hit the planet. Quoting Professor Linda Woodhead, an expert in religious studies and sociology of religion, he writes, in her British Academy lecture setting out the rise of the nuns, the nones, Professor Linda Woodhead suggests that most people today are simply indifferent to churches. People are busy working, trying to survive, or bringing up families. Leisure time can be filled with all manner of amusing things. Pain can be mostly managed. And now even the way in which we view death is being changed, with celebration of a person's life, rather than a ritual for grieving. There seems a strange diminution of life's strangeness, less sense of what W.H. Auden called the baffle of being. We are not alone if we have wondered what the point of religion is. Why bother with God at all? Isn't life all about the family and getting on? But as those who have faith know, life with faith is infinitely richer than life without. In much the same way that reading a book is a much more satisfying experience than watching a film, or visiting a gallery is much better and deeper than reading an art book. Everyone has questions about their existence and the purpose of life. One of the great things about being a human being is that we have self-consciousness. We can see ourselves from outside of ourselves. We can ask, why are we here? What's the reason for it all? And that is a pretty fundamental question, one which religion seeks to explore, not necessarily to answer in a bite. In The Brothers Karamazov, Ivan quotes the old man who is cynical about faith, but even he accepts that faith gives a person a depth of purpose that just living for the mundane can't. I quote, but only he can gain possession of men's freedom who is able to set their conscience at ease. With the bread you are given, an incontestable banner, give him bread and man will worship you, for there is nothing more incontestable than bread. But if at the same time someone besides yourself should gain possession of his conscience, oh, then he will even throw away your bread and follow him who has ensnared his conscience. You are right about that. For the mystery of human life is not only in living, but in knowing why one lives. Without a clear idea of what to live for, man will not consent to live, and will rather destroy himself than remain on the earth, though he were surrounded by loaves of bread. Humans need a purpose. The disciples needed to be put back together after being unpicked by the crucifixion. This happened by the appearance of the resurrected Christ. This is why Thomas believed.
He saw with his own eyes. We do not have the benefit of such incontestable and irrefutable evidence, but we do know that Dostoevsky is right in his writing. People with faith have a reason for living. Christians believe we can know God, can feel his presence, can experience his grace. Seldom, maybe, but it happens. And such moments are like the dawn. They awaken the spirit to continue believing. This is what the resurrection did to those disciples. It woke them up. Amen.
I have read to honest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Visit I, Lord. I have had you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
So let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you, and remain with you now and always. Amen.